It's the 2K Sports Pregame Show.
The Bulls are looking to defeat their Eastern Conference rival going into this one. Here in Philadelphia, it's another home game for the 76ers. And, of course, Kirk Heinrich, team moving on here without him.
You know, what the trade means to me, guys, is they think some of their younger players are ready to spread their wings and take on a little more responsibility. They're going to get more minutes for those guys and allow them to see a little more playing time.
Clearly a forward-thinking deal, you know, and even if his aren't the biggest shoes to fill, it still puts a lot of pressure on your young guys, and let's see if they're ready to fill that void.
All fueled up and ready to go. Check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. Taking a look at the Bulls, Gibson is the forward. Gasol at the five. Butler teamed with Dunleavy on the perimeter. And it's Rose in at the point guard position. Guys, what a nice surprise Tony Roten was last season. Especially effective taking over at the point, Clark, with Michael Carter-Williams gone.
Yeah, Roten put up a career-high 5 assists per game and really worked hard at the defensive end as well. He's one of the few talents on the Sixers roster that hadn't been traded away.
Here's Butler. Jahlil Okafor making his last shot. Rose passes to Butler. Buries the jump shot. A little over a minute gone here in the first quarter. Roten with it. He's coming off a 10-point game against Cleveland. Here's Landry. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
Really strong rebounding on the interior, and he gets the easy putback.
And it's Rose penetrating. Can't hit. Great tee that time from Green. Now here's Roten. He's covered closely. The dish to Okafor. And off the left side of the rim, and it swirls in for him. Okafor's got 6.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
Greg, you're exactly right. I mean, everything seems to be dropping. Impressive scoring here.
Butler kicks to Gasol. Down low, here's Gibson. Good, and the assist goes to Gasol. Gibson's got his first 2 points.
Wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
And the shot is good.
You know, they've scored several times already here in the first quarter down low. I like that.
It's like a running game in football. When you can pound the basketball inside, it also allows you to control a team's transition.
No good from Grant.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on him. Nice work on the inside. Hard to get that one up and over the big fella.
Well, it's not supposed to be easy down there. And A little artistry on the inside helped him make it happen.
Here's Roten following the score by Derrick Rose. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play chance here. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. Scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
Well, I like the fact they've already been getting a lot of high-quality shots in the paint.
Also, guys, the passing has been terrific in the first half. They'll be happy with all those assists.
Outside Gibson, right wing. Bulls moving the ball around. Now here's Roten taking a look at the scoring numbers. Right now he averages about 9 points a game. Here's Okafor, and he can extend the lead to double digits. Bulls trail by 8. Here's Butler. Okafor grabs the miss. Grant dishes to Landry. That's good. Landry's got 6.
Boy, I tell you what, nice little run here they're going on.
And getting to the 10 has been the key. They're getting point-blank looks time and time again.
And the first timeout of the game called for Chicago. They put up a nice win against the Bucks the last time out.
Their percentage from long range in that game was off the charts. Seemed like anytime the fans got a little hostile, they just started to take it up a notch from beyond.
The bombs were really falling, weren't they? I mean, great shooting, especially when you consider it was on the road.
Here's Roten. Jimmy Butler making his last shot. Grant the pass to Okafor. Fader on the way. Second chance shot. No good from Grant.
That's terrific defense right there to prevent from converting in close.
Left side Gibson, stolen by Grant. Green kicks to Roten. The three-pointer no good.
And guys, the Spurs coaching tree extends pretty far these days. Coach Brett Brown, another former member of the Spurs staff, to leading an NBA team.
Greg, for Brett Brown and the Spurs connection. He was an assistant in San Antonio for 7 years, was really indoctrinated into how the Spurs conducted business, Clark, before coming to the 76ers.
Yeah, he's got an interesting accent, too, a mix of Boston, Australian, from where he grew up and where he spent a lot of time, but no doubting his passion and his coaching ability. He's good in both.
He was actually a head coach for Australia for a while, an international play.
Mm-hmm.
And that one's good. 6 points for Jimmy Butler. The 76ers leading by 5. Feeds it to Okafor. Grant's eye. Pass to Landry. And the foul on Derrick Rose. That's his first foul.
Yeah, clearly he had an established position there.
Yeah, and I like this call because you want the refs in that situation. If there's any doubt, err on the side of giving the benefit of the doubt to the offensive player. That should have been a block, and it was.
That is good.
They are attacking the rim and getting great results.
And how? I mean, they're taking this defense to task, taking them to school. Every one of their last 10 points have come in the paint.
Now Grant, the pass to Roten. To the middle, Okafor kicks to Grant. Buries the long-range jumper. Grant's got 5 points.
And the offense has come together immediately. I mean, they're threatening to run away with this thing already.
Greg, it's hard to imagine they'll stay this hot for 4 quarters, but if they even approximate that, watch out.
Yeah, second chance points, a huge issue right now. They're getting steamrolled inside.
Well, guys, nobody's boxing out. I mean, I could go out there and get an offensive rebound. They're just watching. And if you're the coaching staff, that's unacceptable.
And he's made more than his fair share of those today.
The 3. That's miss number 3 for him. Now 2 for 5 from the floor.
And that one gives them a +5 rebound advantage, Kevin.
Pretty clear. They're dominating that area. They've come out with a lot more energy and effort so far.
The 76ers leading by 10. Picked by Okafor. Roten dishes to Green. He kicks to Roten, tries a 3, Here's Landry, rejected by Gasol. Dishes to Dudley. Lets it go from deep. Can't hit. And Philadelphia the other way now. Tough loss coming against Cleveland in their last game played.
And hard to say whether it was the game plan defensively that let them down or just the inability to really bring the fire on that side of the ball.
And guys, it was a bit befuddling to me as to why they stuck with it. I mean, they dug themselves a hole and couldn't find the tweaks they needed to get out of it.
Noel's checked in for Philadelphia. Cannon comes in for Tony Roten. The Bulls also changing it up. Sanders checked in for Gasol. Miritich comes in for Mike Dunleavy. And Brooks subbed in for Rose. Now it's sent it over to Doris Burke, who's able to talk with Brett Brown.
Yes, he's looking at how they can establish an edge in this one. He's looking for them to lock things down on the interior first and foremost. He said our shot blocking is something that can really help us if we just play smart and avoid fouls. We want them shooting over length, and that's one thing my guys do bring to the table. That's a sound strategy, Kevin.
Thank you very much, Doris. So it's mainly about defense for them early on.
And it won't just be early. I mean, it'll be about D all game long.
Yeah, and he made that point very clearly and emphatically to Doris and his players. I think we're going to see an intense defensive performance today.
Tony Snell's checked in for Jimmy Butler.
Again and again, they're dissecting the defense and creating those high-percentage looks from inside.
And even under pressure and close, I think they've still done a good job maintaining concentration and converting the opportunities.
And already they've staked out a noticeable advantage in terms of aggression and controlling the backcourt.
And the trend they'd love to continue right through the next three quarters as well, Greg.
And a huge lead here early to start.
Well, you know, right from the tip, there's not anything they haven't done well so far.
Gibson passes to Sanders. Buries the 20-footer.
Boy, that was a beauty from Larry Sanders.
Philadelphia leading by 13. Here's Cannon. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. And that one's good. Noel.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
You're exactly right. It's been all good at one end. And let's be diplomatic and just say not so good at the other end.
Cannon kicks to Green. To the wing on the left. Philadelphia moving the ball around. Here's Okafor. That's short off the rim. Bulls trail by 13. To the paint. Here's Gibson. Green with the rebound.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
Well, the plan has been obvious now, Clark, for a while. The 76ers really loading up on young players, letting them see a lot of minutes, and hoping it's going to bear some fruit, as you like to say,
yeah,
coming up.
Exactly, and it will in time because they've accumulated some really nice young talent, Kevin.
So at Chicago now, Philadelphia able to drain the three. Great pass to set up the lay-in. Green's got 5 points so far.
Defensively, they've been a step slow here to start.
Giving up too many open shots. I mean, that's what's happening here, Greg. They look to me to be a bit sluggish.
For Chicago, they have shot two free throws, and they're 1-2 so far.
And looking at the numbers this season, they're shooting a robust 82% from the line. That's about as good as it gets.
Those are good numbers for any team. I mean, they can feel extremely good about their free throw shooting percentage this season.
Joel Embiid, he's checked in for Philadelphia. J.K.R. Sampson comes in for Grant. Here's Cannon. Here's Embiid.
No doubt they come into this game with a really aggressive approach, just pounding the ball inside.
It certainly is working. They're finding the open lanes to the hoop and owning this game early. Those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten in the first half here.
And I think they should continue to work the ball down low, Clark. It's really going to free up their outside shooting.
Now here's Embiid. He's averaging around 5.5 points a game.
Boy, they are passing the ball very crisply right now.
They really are, and their last three buckets have come by way of an assist.
Out to the wing. Screen by Sanders. Snell, no good. Philadelphia leading by 18. The drive by Green. That's good. Green Jokic got 7 points.
Excellent ball movement there, guys.
And that's keyed this run. Passing it with purpose. The D hasn't been able to keep up.
And he gets it to go.
He had his head on the swivel and was able to pick out the pass and get the assist.
Philadelphia's gone 3-6, 50% from deep so far tonight. They set the screen. Embiid kicks to Green. Shot is off. Bulls trail by 18. The feed to Snell. He dishes it to Gibson. Nice pass. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup. Gibson's got his third basket of the night right there. Gibson's gotten 3 of his 4 shots to fall, hitting 75%. Embiid with a screen on Brooks. Cannon dishes to Embiid. Terrific design on the pick foot. He lays it in. Embiid's got 6.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
The last 5 trips they've had have ended with a great pass leading to a basket. They're really sharing the sugar.
Philadelphia leading by 18. Passes it to Noel. A baseline J, and the shot is long. Chicago's gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. And Brooks gets it to go.
Such a strong finisher on the fast break.
And Greg, I love the fact he's always in control. Even though he's going at breakneck speed, he still maintains his body control.
Here's Cannon. Sweet little floater. And the 76ers lead by 18.
Uh-oh, a little showboating at the end of that one.
Brooks from outside. Can't get it to go. Domination in the first quarter. It's been pretty lopsided. 76ers on top. Welcome back, everyone. A lopsided first quarter in the books already as we start the second quarter. And a comfortable margin here for the 76ers, guys.
They came out with the purpose of playing for one another, making the extra pass throughout that first quarter.
Guys, that is simply just good basketball. I mean, really good basketball. Total team effort out there.
On the court right now, second quarter for the Bulls. Butler teams with Dunleavy on the perimeter. Mirotić is out there with Pau Gasol. And it's Rose in at the one. Pass to Landry. And it falls over the rim and in. Landry's got the second quarter going with the first basket of the period for Philadelphia. Rose passes to Dunleavy. It's good. This time the assist from Rose. Rose has got 3 assists now in this one. Philadelphia leading by 18. Roten kicks to Sampson. He feeds it to Jackson. The dish to Embiid. Can't get it to go. So the Bulls will take it the other way. Following this one, they get to host the Mavericks. That game is the first and last of their home street. Bulls have shot 75% at the line tonight, going 3 for 4. And he knocks down the first one. And some changes here for the 76ers. Okafor's checked in, and it's Jeremy Grant in for Jakarr Sampson. And he makes both free throws. Philadelphia's gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. They double him with Butler. Roden kicks to Landry. From 12 feet out. A second chance effort. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot 2. The 76ers shooting their second and third free throws tonight.
And when you think of free throw shooting, not particularly a strength for this group, right around 70%.
And comparing to the numbers of last season, they've made a bit of improvement. So that's some positive momentum they can look to build on.
Here's Dunleavy. A 17-point game for him in the win against the Bucks in Milwaukee. Butler. Another field goal for him. 4 for 6 shooting tonight.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Everybody on the same page, completely in sync. Tremendous communication and awareness.
Now here's Okafor. He had 15 points last outing. Rose against Jackson. Got a piece of it. Oh, and a fast break for the Bulls. And slam dunk by Butler.
Whoa, quick hands
on the steal and then just mad hops on the slam.
Great sequence for them defensively and Clark offensively.
Well, one usually leads to the other, Kevin. That's just good, aggressive, attacking basketball at both ends.
Here's Landry. The Bulls getting the bucket. Cannot hit. And for Carl Landry, he powered his way through the league a few years back, but somewhere along the line, Clark, his game kind of topped out.
His best season, Kevin, he averaged 18-7. I think injuries have been a factor, but last year was down to 7-4 his game averages, so he's starting to slide.
Chicago calls timeout.
And back to Carl Landry, sophisticated scorer, a variety of post moves, a tough guy willing to play through pain, but he just never had the size or explosiveness to dominate. And now that he's getting a little older, that really has become an issue.
Now here's Roten, 8 points for him, kicks it to Grant. And he dunks it down.
Really crisp, intelligent passing to make that basket possible.
Bulls trail by 17.
You know, visiting Carl Landry again here, I mean, he's a role guy. He shoots a high percentage from the field, from the foul line, gives you a little nasty and edge down low, yet you can't make him out to be more than he is.
Here's Roten. Jimmy Butler making his last shot. Landry with the screen. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Landry's been putting up the numbers. He has 8 points and a steal.
He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now. No good on that one.
Yeah, the NBA Development League now celebrating its 15th anniversary, and a lot of change over that time. None of the original eight teams still playing in their original locations. Still, it's only growing. And I think we'll see it grow to 30 teams before long.
Now here's Rose. He's coming off a 16-point game against the Bucks in Milwaukee.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
And what I like about it, Greg, it's been a physical brand of basketball. It's had a little sandpaper element to it. Gritty and rough, but that's how you win games.
Greg, you're talking about the D-League. Not really a moneymaker yet, but it's really benefited, Clark, the NBA in so many ways.
Clearly has, Kevin, a place to train new players, officials, and executives or management, a way to test out possible rule changes. I think building revenue is the focus, though, and the players make a small salary, but the NBA Developmental League is helping the NBA be better.
And the 76ers decide to take their first time out here.
You know, I think he just wants to tinker with the game plan a little bit, and I think that's a wise timeout.
And part of it, too, Greg, was he saw some things going on out there that he didn't care for.
And here are the 76ers now. They led the game at 1 point by 20. Victory eluded them last time in Chicago when they faced the Bulls.
And talk about a team that just never seemed to get into a rhythm offensively. It was just an ugly game to watch.
Yeah, that's an understatement. I mean, they didn't appear to have any kind of cohesiveness in terms of game plan. And they never figured out how to attack the defense in them.
Here's Roten, following the score by Derrick Rose. Landry dishes to Roten.
And what a sensational finish right there. I mean, fundamentals defensively are not enough when you go against an elite level athlete like this fella.
I'm not sure it's ever a good idea to get in his way.
I think there's a lot of guys out there who agree with you on that one, fellas.
And that last replay courtesy of Kia. And it's a go. Houghton's got 12 in the game.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
Here's Gasol. Makes it off the glass.
I love how he establishes his post position inside before he converts.
Roten, the pass to Okafor. It's good for his fourth bucket of the night. He's shooting 4 of 8.
The number of points they've scored in the paint already today is pretty eye-opening.
It really is, Clark. The defenders need to do a better job of closing those lanes to the hoop.
Now here's Rose. He's got five. That's good.
Just reliable, guys. He's just always trying to make the right play.
Now here's Roden, defended by Butler. Here's Jackson, and it's blocked by Miritich. Butler kicks to Rose, and he gets it to go.
And fellas, in this quarter, he's improved on what was already a very good performance in period number one.
Rose, unbelievable spirit. We know about his toughness, has fought through injuries of all kinds that might cause a lesser competitor to hang up his sneakers.
And competitor, that's the word, Kevin. I mean, he was impossible to outcompete at the high school level, the college level, and now in the pros.
Now here's Jackson. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game.
Look at the big fella working on that possession. He knows how to fend guys off and get those rebounds. I mean, that can happen to anyone, but it's ugly every time it does.
Yeah, it is unfortunate and embarrassing. He just lost his concentration for a split second, and that's all it took.
But he recovers it. That's good. Grant's got 4 points in the quarter.
And guys, that kind of sums it up right there. I mean, one team getting after it, hustling the rebounds, the putbacks. The other team just a step slow.
Inside. That's good. And it's Jackson with the assist that time. Grant's got 18 points in the game.
And, you know, back to D. Rose for a moment. He drives the lane now as hard as he did before the injuries. It's a level of fearlessness that only a few guys possess. And it's not teachable. You either have it or you don't.
Now here's Roden, following the miss by Derrick Rose. Now here's Rose, the fast break opportunity. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Miritich dishes to Dunley. To the inside, Gasol. A shot from the low post is good. Gasol's got his second basket of the night.
And you know, back to D. Rose. He grew up in a brutally dangerous neighborhood on Chicago's south side. Some of that fearlessness, that competitiveness he exhibits, was learned early on out of necessity.
It's with the drive. Shot clock at 6. No good from Grant.
Well, it looks like he's cooled down a bit after hitting those two in the first quarter.
Rose, no good. The 76ers leading by 15. On the wing, Jackson, defended by Dunleavy. Jackson kicks to Okafor. And Miritich sends it back. And out of bounds it is. Last touch by Miritich. Some changes for Philadelphia. Noel's checked in for Landry. Green comes in for Roten. And it's Cannon in for Jackson. The Bulls also changing it up. Larry Sanders is checked in for Gasol. Gibson comes in for Miritich. And Brooks subbed in for Rose. Bulls trail by 15. The shot by Butler. Nobody around. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Butler's got 19 points.
Great quarter for him at the offensive end, trying to will his team back in the game.
There's a screen by Noel. Cannon kicks to Noel. The drive by Green. Can't connect from 14 feet out. To the inside. Stolen by Grant. Cannon, the pass to Noel. That's in. He's got 2 made now, and he's shooting 2 for 3.
Give credit where credit is due right there. A terrific assist.
And he gets the bucket. 6 points for Larry Sanders.
Huge hole in the defense that possession. He didn't waste any time cutting through it.
Deflects the pass. Here's Okafor. Can't hit. Good D by Sanders.
Not really his best quarter as far as scoring. Let's see if he can eventually get back on track.
Boy, there was a little extra on that one, fellas. Nobody's going to stop that.
Not when he comes in with the tomahawk. That's just too much force.
Goodness, you cannot punch it any harder than that.
Now here's Green. 9-point game, his last outing. Noel down low. Gibson on him. And that one's good. Noel.
Another gap in the defense found there, and they've really had their number today.
Nice. Sanders against Okafor. And he stuffs it. What a pass to set him up.
And if that doesn't get them fired up, guys, nothing will.
Greg, just what the doctor ordered, huh? Some high-flying antics to narrow the deficit.
Tell you what, fellas, that could give them the energy boost they've been looking for.
You know, not necessarily what you're looking for, but still able to convert.
Bulls trail by 12. Green with the rebound.
You know, so many games are decided by which team wins the rebound battle. And that's held true in this one so far.
And Clark, their effort on the glass has given them the advantage, but it's also been the effort in general that's made a difference.
Complete domination. What a game for Okafor. He has 9 points, and the steals are starting to pile up for him also.
And Clark, he's really gotten into their heads because of it. I mean, guys are on the lookout for him, always worrying about where he is.
Jakar Sampson's checked in for Grant, and the Bulls making a change also. Tony Snell's checked in for Dunleavy.
Cutting into the lead with a huge one-hand throwdown.
That's how to get your team back into it.
Yes, sir.
I tell you what, guys, that might also put a little spark into those guys.
Here's Cannon. Floats one up, and the rejection by Sanders. And the wide-open shot from Green. Off target from outside.
He hit a three in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
Three-pointer, Snell. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. Butler's got 3 assists in the game.
A wide-open three. They need much better communication defensively.
Philadelphia with the ball. They led the game at 1 point by 20.
Clearly a two-for-one situation here, guys.
Oh, without question, Greg. I mean, the wise move would be to get themselves a quick shot so they have an opportunity to get that two-for-one.
And that's how you make a steal count. Turn it into a quick slam at the other end.
It was really a case. It looked like Greg Anthony right there, if I can say so. It was really a case of a great defensive play triggering some instant offense.
Yeah, I remember GA as an irritant. And this guy, much like Greg, creating havoc out there. He just has not been able to get into that groove yet, guys. But as a whole, it hasn't affected them too much. Cutting into that lead a little bit. Way to finish.
And the basket is still shaking.
Oh, I mean, he has got power in bunches on that two-hand.
Sampson dishes to Noel. And the shot is good. Noel's got 8 points.
Oh, and look at how well he led him in there. Really, he passed him open for that dish.
Oh, a monumental buzzer beater!
What a thrilling shot for one team and a heartbreaker for the other.
Simply fantastic. Cool as...
And the first half comes to a conclusion in a game that has been very close so far.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here. Right out of the gates, it was Philadelphia setting the tone. They went on what can only be described as an unbelievable run, pushing the lead out to 20 points. And they ended their mad dash in the first quarter with a formidable 18-point lead. And now, folks, it's just about...
Jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. We are seeing a tremendous game from Jimmy Butler.
Yeah, he's played just a smart game overall offensively, looking for and finding the gaps in the defense, and also terrific shot selection.
Greg, that's exactly what we're talking about when we talk about being efficient as an offensive player. Fully on display there with him.
They've got Grant, Okafor out there with Carl Landry. Then it's Tony Roten, and it's Green in at the shooting guard position. And that's the group for Brett Brown as we begin the second half. Here's Gasol. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. Butler's got assist number 5 here tonight.
And you know what? One of the few bright spots in this game for them today. He's kept his edge even though they've been trailing.
Rejected by Gasol. Feeds it to Dunleavy. Shot from 12. And the Bulls tack on 2 more.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
10 straight points off assist. That's very impressive. And it also makes the game easy and fun to watch.
Grant gets to Okafor. Philadelphia moving the ball around. Roten Walton. The pass to Okafor. This is to Landry. Back to Okafor. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
And quickly, let's look at the numbers for Dunleavy. Second in three-point field goal percentage. And he's in the top 10 in field goal percentage. Really able to power his way to the bucket and finish through contact.
And back to your point, I mean, a lot of his effectiveness has to do with mental toughness. It's just hard to force him out of his comfort zone.
So 1-for-2 that time at the stripe. Bulls trail by 4.
Pau Gasol was the number 3 pick back in 2001. He managed to average 18-9 his first season, was rookie of the year, became a perennial all-star. There's no way his younger brother Mark, who was a second-round pick, could ever match up to that, right? Not so fast, people. Mark's pretty good, too.
And out of bounds as the Bulls gain possession. And while we have a chance, here are the teams that have swatted away the most shots this season. The Bulls third.
I mean, terrific rim protection. I mean, they rotate and help on the inside as well as anybody. And, of course, you want to keep offenses on the outside shooting jump shots, and that continues to be the goal.
He certainly didn't take advantage of the poor defense, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
I tell you what, I think he'd be happy if he can continue to get looks like that.
Okafor kicks to Roque. To the wing right side. And it's Grant in the corner. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And they force the shot clock violation. Great D. Let's check out the Eastern Conference standings now that we're in the new year. Taking a look at Chicago. They're in the middle at 5th in the conference, looking to build in the wins as the season goes on. And, of course, the 76ers, 7.5 games behind.
And, you know, for the Bulls, they've fulfilled a lot of the promise they showed coming into the season. But they just haven't taken that next leap forward so many thought they might.
I was one of those who was thinking that thought, that they would take a big leap. Still not too late. No better place to get right and tight than at the postseason.
The Bulls have made 6 of their 7 attempts at the line in this one.
Some excellent numbers in this one for Butler. 25 points and 5 assists. He is in complete control of this game.
Clark, you're on the money with that one. It's all going his way.
And he's checked in for the 76ers. Embiid the screen. Here's Landry. And a kind roll that time off the rim as that one falls. Landry's got 13.
That's a nice job of getting the ball in the paint and burying the shot. That's exactly how it's done.
Chicago calls timeout. You look at Jeremy Grant, what a contribution.
He's on fire. And they needed to put their heads together to figure out how to get the ball out of his hand.
Embiid with the steal. Chicago grabs the miss. Butler's got his 3rd rebound on the night. Moving it up and finished off by Rose.
And really, he epitomizes what a point guard should be. I mean, his skills as a passer might actually be matched by that creativity he shows around the rim.
Well, judging by that jam, Greg, I'd say you're absolutely right.
Boy, that's a nice surge for them just when they needed it in a game that was so tight.
A little under 2.5 minutes off the clock now here in the 3rd. Down low. And it's Gibson finishing it off.
You know, there are a lot of bigger power forwards than him in the NBA, but very few that rise up like he can.
Now here's Roten. He's covered by Rose. And that one's good. Roten. Bulls trail by 3. Inside. Here's Butler. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it 3.
Those defenders look like they're out of gas. I mean, they're getting pushed around on the low block.
Yeah, but they better rally soon because they've given up 3 straight buckets in the paint.
Miritich has checked in for Taj Gibson. Bulls have gone 7 of 9 from the free throw line tonight. And it's tied up with that one. 76ers have gone 4-7 to get things started here in the second half. Now here's Roten. He Rockets covered by Rose. Grant gets a wide open look. And it's Chicago with the rebound.
Most of the time, that shot will go down. Boy, the defenders have to make sure they tag.
Rose, no good.
Now, nice work there to contest the finish inside.
You know, they got the shot they wanted, but his defense, I mean, deterred them from those plans.
Bulls have gone 6 of 8 on field goal attempts in the third. A 75% clip. Dunleavy dishes to Butler.
All the officials are all that.
Clearly a foul. I mean, didn't give him any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you got to play without foul.
For Chicago, they have shot 8 of 10 from the line. That's an even 80% free throw shooting here. Jackson, he's checked in for Philadelphia. And that drops, so they now lead by one.
They're ahead, but if they don't get a stop here, that free throw could prove critical.
Now here's Roten. He's guarded closely. Landry, a screen on Buck. Roten, another miss by Philadelphia.
Good pick, but he just couldn't make it count.
Yeah, nice job of setting the screen by his teammate there. I'm sure he appreciated it.
Good shot selection, long range, and the defender all up in your jersey.
And you know, that's just the kind of defensive work he's known for. I mean, he can take that shot away from you and does it more times than not.
Now Chicago has gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Pass to Dunleavy. Fires the three. And Embiid pulls it down.
Boy, he's got a nice looking stroke. That almost went in.
Yeah, and a lot of times he'll still knock those down no matter how good the D is.
How about that fantastic finish and the aggressive move too, Kevin?
Trying to send a message, Clark, with that slam, I think.
And I'm not sure if it was text or email, but he definitely threw that one down.
Here's Butler. Shakes off the strong D and gets the bucket for two. Butler's got 7 points for the quarter. The 76ers lead it. Inside, here's Landry, and he uses both hands to jam it in.
Heads up play there, guys, on the assist and the pass.
Bulls have gone 7 of 11, a lucky field goal percentage here in the third. And the pass to Gasol. Landry grabs the miss. Landry's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Outside, Green. Tipped away. Andre passes to Jackson. Rebound by the Bulls.
He's got to be disappointed with himself on that one. He has got to knock those down.
Butler kicks to Rose. Back to Butler. From 13. No good. Great D that time from Green. And there's the feed to Embiid. Landry in the post, suspended by Dunleavy. Landry no good. Bulls trail by 3. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. That's good.
Yeah, it's just a smart shot taking advantage of the mismatch.
Well, with a stroke like that and the height advantage as well, the mid-range J is almost a gimme.
There was a question of whether or not Derrick Rose would be able to get back to his former self. At times last season, you could see him back in that MVP form.
Here's what Philadelphia's going with right now. Erwin's Noel checks in for Landry. J.K.R. Simpson comes in for Daniel Green. And it's Cannon in for Jackson. Bulls have gone 8-14 on their shot attempts here in the third. Some pretty nice work. Mirotic's shot is off. With Rose again, he showed flashes last season of his level of play, Clark, before the injuries.
Yeah, exactly. And you hate to see any player go down with injuries, especially a talent like Derrick Rose. He still needs to show that he can regain that high level of NBA play for an entire season. I think that's just a matter of time, Kevin.
And a look at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for Philadelphia.
Boy, guys, I really like how they've driven the ball to the basket in this game. I mean, they've been very aggressive with it.
Yeah, but I also like the balance because they're doing a great job of getting inside and converting around the rim. I really like their aggressiveness.
Not a typical trip to the line for him there. He had been knocking them down today.
Brooks misses.
Boy, just by his body language, Kevin, you can tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Yeah, It seemed like he had great rhythm on that. You can see the disappointment in his face.
Here's Simpson, plays it up and in on the nice reverse.
You gotta love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of grinded out physical game.
That's the kind of look they can continue to go with. Maybe that'll help them create some separation on the scoreboard.
There's the pick. Out of bounds, Philadelphia takes possession. Well, from long range, we've got a set of point guards here that have been extremely hot. Those are their three-point percentages for the last 10 games. In the third spot, Aaron Brooks.
A lot of point guards in the NBA don't get enough credit for how well they shoot the basketball. So give this group their due, some outstanding long-range shooters.
No doubt about it. And being as accurate in three-point land as these guys are makes them that much more valuable as point guards. Opposing defenses have to worry about their passing and their shooting.
And here is Mirotić. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Five on the clock, count it, and the 76ers lead has been cut down to two on the bucket from Brooks.
And really, how about the quick release on that triple there, because he's given up a lot of height in that matchup.
Right on target you are, Greg. I mean, the quick release is what made the difference there. Any hesitation, and that shot is being blocked.
There's a screen by Noel. Cannon dishes to Noel. Look at that jam!
And you talk about momentum. That sort of action delivers a type of energy to your team that you just can't quantify.
You know what? I'm going to quantify it right now, Clark. And this is a close game, and that was something special.
And really, in a game, you guys, in a game like this, though, when you have a chance to send a message, you do. And boy, did he ever on that play.
That Kia Slam Cam replay really gave you a good look at the action. And Philadelphia making a change here. Okafor's checked in. This all no good. The 76ers leading by four. Out left of the wing. Cannon, that's a two-pointer. Rebound collected by Snell. Chicago has gotten one of six three-pointers to drop since coming out of the locker room at halftime. Got that one up quick. And 11 points for Brooks. The 76ers shooting at 52% from the field. They're clicking. Roden kicks to Sampson. There's a screen. He dishes it to Cannon. Now here's Roden. Tight defense on him. It's stolen. And there's a minute 45 left in the third. Sanders' shot is good.
Excellent work offensively to get that shot attempt into a can't-miss area.
Cannon, the pass to Noel. He kicks to Roten, expanding his range. The shot is off. And the Bulls going the other way now. Bulls moving the ball around. Out to the right wing. Mirotić has a wide-open look. And that misses. That would have put him up. Philadelphia's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Roten dishes to Noel. Poked loose. It's hauled in by the Bulls. Gasol's got his fifth rebound in this one. And Mirotić kicks to Snell. For the lead. And it's Brooks. That time on the assist by Gasol. And that's 13 points for Aaron Brooks. The 76ers trail. Down low, Noel scores the bucket. He's 7 for 11 and continues to look good.
Man, he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
Snell, the pass to Sanders. the fourth quarter of action getting underway. We've had a great one so far with both sides coming to play. The 76ers shooting has been great, up over 50%. In fact, 52%. So for Chicago right now, Rose is the one with Butler as the two. Gibson is the four with Gasol at the five. And it's Dunleavy in at the three. Here's Landry, and it is flushed down with a nice jam.
And that's the kind of lead pass we've come to expect from him.
Gibson passes to Dunleavy. He feeds it to Rose. Green against Butler. Gasol a screen. Down to five on the shot clock. Green shot on the way. Shot is off. And it's Philadelphia the other way. And here comes the break. Finished off the break. Now it's a four-point 76ers lead.
And it doesn't really matter who starts the break with how he runs the floor. He seems to always be the one who finishes.
Yeah, he is so fun to watch and how he attacks the rim at full speed like that, man. It's something to behold the way that guy gets to the rim.
Pushing it up. Landry grabs the miss. Landry's got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one. And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul. Shot misses. He'll be shooting two.
Been a great game tonight for Green. He has 11 points. And what a game he's had passing the ball, too.
I love the fact that he plays for his teammates, really spreading the ball around, getting everyone involved.
Joel Embiid, he's checked in for Okafor. Gasol kicks to Butler. Good, and the assist goes to Gasol. 34 points for Jimmy Butler.
That is not the time to be giving him that kind of shot.
And here's Green outside. Offensive rebound, Embiid. And he uses the glass on the layup.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside.
I tell you, we're taking a look at some real deficiency.
Oh!
I don't know that this is the time for that kind of flair. In a close game, the important thing is the 2 points. Not the dramatic.
Oh, come on, Clark. He had to go for it, didn't he?
Yeah, perhaps.
Hey, he's an athlete, and I can't fault him for that one, although if he missed it, I might have.
And there's the three-second call, this one on the defense. And, guys, the Sixers drafted Embiid third overall despite a foot injury that would keep him out all of his rookie season. Came to the Sixers with a back issue out of Kansas. Of course, they knew all this going in.
Yeah. And Kevin, the Sixers have made an art here lately of drafting players who aren't immediately eligible to play. 2 years ago was Nerlens Noel, who set out the season with a knee injury. Last year was Dario Saric, who played overseas, and now Embiid.
76ers have gone 3 of 4 in field goal attempts since getting things started here in the fourth. And the foul on Derrick Rose. That's foul number 2 for him. Jackson, he's checked in for Cannon.
Pierre Jackson.
Fourth quarter of play, and we're about 2.5 minutes through it right now. And Gibson sends it back. They retain possession, and he gets it to go.
Oh, they own the interior right now. 10 straight points coming from inside.
Well, constantly finding lanes to the basket, getting great looks inside.
And the foul on Derrick Rose. That's his third foul of the game. The 76ers making a switch here. Roten's checked in.
Tony Roten.
Andrew with the screen. And here's Green outside. Again, the miss by Green.
1 made 3 form for the game. Does he focus closer in? Let's see.
And that is good. 16 points for Derrick Rose.
And they'll be counting on even more points from him. That's essential if they're going to pull this game out.
Green, the screen, and the foul on Derrick Rose. That will get him his fourth foul of the game.
Well, it's still early in the quarter, and they're only one foul away from being over the limit.
Here's Landry. Outside, Green. Roten gets to Embiid. Passes it to Landry. Let's it go from 11. It's hauled in by the Bulls to take the lead. Great, the block, and they'll keep possession. Rose dishes to Gibson and can't hit the shot, but they're saying he got hacked, so he'll head to the free throw line. The It's on Carl Lent.
When you're hot, you're hot. And that's certainly been the case for Gibson. He has 14 points and 2 blocks. What a force he's been in the paint.
And he's gotten himself into the air, Clark, so often blocking shots and getting rebounds.
And that falls, and that puts him up by 1 point. Philadelphia's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Embiid against Gasol. Screen by Grant. Andrea screen on Rhodes. Here's Roten. An easy layup after coming off the pick. Roten's got 20 points. There is just no way, Clark, to tell who is going to pull this one out.
You know what, Kevin? I think looking at this game, it may very well come down to one crucial key play.
Clark, that's a great point. When you've had this many lead changes, you're looking to see which one of those plays is going to be a momentum swinger.
Bulls trail by 3. Here's Gasol. Offensive rebound. Three-pointer, Butler. Good, and the assist goes to Gasol. 39 points for Butler.
Boy, guys, they've shown some great passing on their last few trips down the floor. Excellent.
4 straight passes leading to scores. Great team play.
Roten with it. Here's Embiid. And he goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down.
He is an automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
You know, he picks the simple one-handed stuff to get the 2 points.
Yeah, and in a close game, though, guys, those could be really important points. And you like to see since the half now, he's finally starting to come around.
Roten, the pass to Embiid. Grant kicks to Roten. Great D that time from Gibson.
Well, one of his issues is he's a player that just does not excel at fighting through contact on his way to the rim.
And you give them a lot of credit for just battling back into this game.
Extremely impressive was the rally they made. I mean, we'll see how much their comeback might have taken out of them, and we'll see if they can keep that foot on the pedal now.
The turnaround jumper, and Gibson sends it back. Gasol kicks to Rose. Here's Dunleavy, and it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Landry's got his 8th rebound here tonight. Here's Roten, but they get it back. Grant dishes to Landry. The 76ers again can't hit it. Chicago leading, outside Butler. 17-foot shot on the way. Count the buckets. 14 points for Pau Gasol.
You know, he was a non-factor in that first half, but now he's making up for lost time.
Here's Roten. Timeout called, the 76ers.
And he clearly doesn't like what's going on out there right now.
Would you? I mean, how could he like what's happening? Really had to take a timeout there and try to figure out a way to derail their momentum.
Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Brett Brown as he addressed his team. He told his guys, time's running low. If we're going to make our move, it's going to be now. Are you guys ready? And as they nodded, he said, let's go get it. Kevin?
Pass to Landry. Addition out to Grant. They double him with Butler. Grant with the ball. Butler covering from deep. Green looks good, is good. That's his 7th basket in 12 tries.
A good look there, and he didn't waste it. His 2nd 3 of the game.
Rose passes to Butler. Landry grabs the miss. Landry's got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. And out of bounds as the Bulls gain possession. Erland's Noel checks in for the 76ers. Here is Rose. To the middle. Here's Gibson. It's good. This time the assist from Rose. 18 points here for Taj Gibson.
Just carrying the load right now offensively, guys. He is not wasting any chances.
From where I sit, Greg, it's a simple deduction. If they want things to be easy on themselves here late,
make sure he has the ball.
And it's Chicago scoring again.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Well, when you look at the assist totals, heck, they've been clearly the better team.
And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Bulls.
Fantastic passing. We saw it in the first half, and it's carried over here in the second.
They haven't wasted time getting the ball up the court tonight either, and it's resulted in a lot of fast break points. Excellent game we've seen from Tony Roten. He has 20 points and 10 assists also. He's been tough on the inside and displayed great vision with his passing too.
You know what? He is the total package today, giving them a little bit of everything.
And it's Butler with the jam.
A splendid pass that time by Rose.
So it's Philadelphia now. They trail by 9 points. Green, the screen. Up top, Roten. Defended by Butler. And that one's good. Roten. Roten's got 10 points in just the second half.
D cannot forget about him like that. He'll light you up big time.
Here's Gibson. Rose kicks to Butler. Back to Rose. Six to shoot. And he gets it to go. And the Bulls lead by 9.
It's as if the defenses have just given up.
Yeah, you know, the pace has only picked up the deeper we've gotten into this game, which is remarkable. It speaks to the endurance and stamina of these teams. And it's also been a lot of fun to watch.
Andrea, screen on Butler. Roten, no good. Here's Chicago. They're on a 19-7 run. And it's Butler missing. Philadelphia's gone into a funk from downtown in the fourth. Only one of their 5 three-pointers has found the bottom of the bucket. There's Green with the three. Chicago grabs the miss. Gibson's got double-digit rebounds now in the game. And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession.
And really no choice but to lunge for that pass to make sure it didn't get through.
Yeah, and that was important. Probably would have been a quick 2 points if he doesn't get a hand on it and knock it out of bounds.
And so here is Chicago. Knocks it loose and stolen by Noel. Here's Grant. Kicks it to Roten. Nice D from Rose.
You know what? His finishing ability, not really at the level that you would expect from a pro, but he's going to have to start playing with more force.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
You got to find something, you're right. They kick it out to Green, pulls up from the corner, bounces high off the rim and drops. Green's got 21 in the game.
And he's clearly led the way offensively. The question is, can they ride him and get back into it?
Here's Butler. Yes, and it's Rose with the assist that time. Butler's got the lead up to 9 now for the Bulls. Timeout called, the 76ers.
And you can tell they're just a little out of sync. I think he just wants to get everybody back. On the same page.
Yeah, I like this timeout, Greg. I think it's a good one because it looks like they need a minute to talk things through here.
.156 left here in the fourth quarter. Roten dishes to Green. Now here's Roten, defended by Butler. Fast break, here comes Chicago. Can't extend the lead to double digits.
Major defensive lapse right there. And he's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. You've got to stay attached to him. They're lucky he couldn't punish them for it.
Here's Roten. And it's Gasol with the rebound.
Well, it's been a turbulent quarter. Really rough for him. Nothing going his way. But he seems determined to shoot his way out of it.
Here's Butler. And he lays it straight in. Butler's got 49 points in the game.
And we'll just watch the clock wind down, guys, in what will turn out to be a win here for the Bulls.
You're right, Steve. This has got to feel good. I mean, they never counted themselves out when they were down earlier. And now, Clark, they not only muscled their way back into the game, but wow, they're in a position, shockingly, to win easily.
I think this epitomizes the will to win. You have to admire the perseverance of never doubting your teammates, your coaches, the team stay together. I really like what I've seen here tonight. They definitely earned this.
And so looking at their number, this will be win number 22 on the year.
And they will walk out of here feeling really good about themselves today, guys. A big win over conference foe. They split their previous two games with.
Greg, they've got one more game left against them, and there's no doubt they'll use this as a jumping off point to take another game off them later in the year. At least that's the plan.
And you have to look back at this and see the huge game it was for Butler. He was doing everything right, and the points came in bunches. Definitely had the hot hand.
Gibson with the steal. And Butler, here we go. The rim-rattling two-handed jam.
And they've just done a great job of keeping... this crowd out of the game, and we're getting closer to victory. The crowd's getting quieter,
and there's not a whole lot for them to be cheering about anymore. I mean, their guys got it handed to them. Tell you what, the defense has nothing to worry about out there with him shooting. I mean, he can't dial it in from deep this half at all.
Gibson passes to Butler. The wing jumper off target.
Not really sure what he was thinking about on that shot. That is not high IQ basketball.
Not at all. I mean, he shouldn't even have considered taking that shot. Just a poor choice there.
And it's Noel missing. And so Chicago takes this one, and by a big margin. They came in here and took care of business like they were the home team.
And Kevin, how about the mental toughness that this group showed? They were never yes. rattled at all by the opposing fans.
And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Derek, congratulations on a great win. What was the major thing that turned this deficit around for you guys?
Just playing defense. Our defense turned into offense, and it worked out for us tonight.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Welcome back, everybody. Ernie Johnson here along with Shaq and the Jet as we present our Jordan player of the game, Jimmy Butler. It was nothing short of a professional offensive clinic he put on today. He hit shots from every place he took them, and he took a lot of them to score more than 50 points.
I don't know what got into him tonight. Whew. He caught the scoring bug and was just pouring it in the paint. That's the kind of offense he's capable of delivering when he sets his mind to it.
Just an unreal performance for him in so many ways. That was a player at the absolute top of his game. It's hard to imagine someone being any more dominant than he was tonight.
And that'll do it for tonight.